Welcome to my daytime. My name is Mary Star, and I hope you guys are having a wonderful time on my channel, because I'm really excited to be here to kind of like bring you guys the latest entertainment news and all the things that has been going around this week. Anyway, today I'm going to be talking about Brad Pitt texting his ex-wife Jennifer Aniston. And first of all, when I heard this, I was like thinking, I was kind of like really happy, because you know, I'm kind of like a romantic diehard, and if you're one of those people who know the, you know, the history between Brad Pitt and Jennifer Aniston, you know that their split was really, really sad for Jennifer Aniston, because you know, every woman knows that when a man leaves you for another woman, it's one of those hateful things that a woman can never go through. So just recently I saw a story where it was saying that Brad Pitt has been texting Jennifer Aniston, and this is kind of a quagmire, to be honest. This is like literally drama, because first of all, Jennifer Aniston is now married to somebody else, and it's quite disrespectful of Brad Pitt to kind of like be contacting Jen after 10 years of them breaking off. And the question that I wanted to ask people before I go on expressing what I think about this whole new relationship between Jennifer Aniston and Brad Pitt is it okay for, you know, for two people who are kind of like exes to be friends again? Because you know, for me, I'm kind of like really personal. If I kind of like dump a guy, that's it, that's the end of it. I'm not gonna be contacting you again. And if a man cheated on me, I'm not gonna be even talking to you. But you know, this is kind of like one of those maybe vengeful things that women do, because you know, sometimes when someone really hates you very badly, you kind of like tend to have resentment. And I personally kind of like experienced that. One of my exes really cheated on me and was really, really mean. And later on in life, he kind of like tried to, you know, contact me and be friends with me on Facebook. And it was, you know, by that time I'd already married my husband. And in my heart, I kind of like really felt excited. I was like really, really happy that he was, you know, he was calling me back, because I kind of like, it was kind of like sweet revenge. It's like you just feel like, now you can have me when you want me. So that is why I kind of like really related to this story about Brad Pitt, you know, texting Jennifer Aniston. And you know, Jennifer Aniston is one of those American sweethearts. A lot of people like her. She's kind of like really one of those nice girls. And you know, she has a trials and tribulation, you know, because a lot of people are always talking about her not having children. And sometimes she kind of like goes in the media and expresses her feelings that, you know, I'm just not a woman to be pregnant, you know, I'm happy with my life, so people should just kind of like stop talking about me not having children. And you know, a lot of stories came up, you know, like saying that, you know, she's so disappointed with being dumped by Brad Pitt, and that's why she never had children. But I think after 10 years, I kind of like really feel like maybe she's not ready to have children, or maybe she cannot have children, you know, because sometimes women, we kind of like put under pressure to have children, and you know, sometimes she might not be able to bear children, you know, because there's some women who have certain problems that don't allow them to have children. Anyway, back to Brad Pitt texting his ex-wife. First of all, this Brad Pitt has got really nerves, because you remember Brad Pitt, you know, dumped Jennifer Aniston after he met, you know, seductress Angelina Jolie on the set of Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Right, so if you don't know the history, what happened between the two, I'm going to kind of like go back in history and kind of like keep you, you know, guys updated with what really happened. So in 2004, 2005, somewhere there, Brad Pitt was filming Mr. and Mrs. Smith. And during him filming this, you know, kind of like comedy, thriller, kind of like spy movie with Angelina Jolie, they two kind of like really fell in love. And what was sad is that by that time, allegedly, Brad Pitt was still married to you know, Jennifer Aniston, and by that time she was in Friends, and she's also one of the American sweethearts. So they're kind of like, their breakup was really, really messy, because first of all, a lot of women kind of like were team, and you know, Jennifer Aniston, because you know, she was married to Brad Pitt by that time, 5 years in their relationship. And unfortunately, when Brad Pitt met said actress Angelina Jolie, kind of like really done a runner on Jennifer Aniston. And you know, from that moment, Jennifer Aniston has always kind of like lived in the shadow of being Mrs. Pitt. And you know, she couldn't move on because, you know, people kept on reminding her about, you know, her breakup with Brad Pitt. And anyway, Brad Pitt went ahead and kind of like married Angelina Jolie. They even had 600 children, not really 600, I'm kind of like exaggerating. They had kind of like 6 children, of course. I think 4 were theirs, and others were adopted by Angelina Jolie before they even got married. And so, when I heard that actually, you know, Brad Pitt was breaking up with Angelina Jolie, I was kind of like really happy, because I always feel like, you know, the way you win a man is exactly how you're gonna lose them. Because first of all, Angelina Jolie stole Brad Pitt from Jennifer Aniston, but people would argue as well that, you know, if someone is able to steal your man, then he wasn't your man to begin with. But you know, there are just women out there who don't really play fair when it comes to relationship. There are women who lay on their back and do everything to steal your man. And you know, men, sometimes men cannot just help themselves, and most of the time men don't really use their brains once they want to test the cookie. But I'm kind of like generalizing, because I know that not all men are like that. But this is what Brad Pitt did. He kind of like dumped Jennifer Aniston for Angelina Jolie, and he kind of like sort of looked like he was really having a good time with Angelina Jolie. The couple, you know, managed to be married for I think they were together for 15 years. But just recently, there were rumors in the media that Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie were getting divorced, because apparently Angelina Jolie is the one who actually filed for divorce, because she was saying that Brad Pitt was smoking dope and was like really being a drunkard and was also abusing their children. And there was an incident that happened in the plane that kind of like opened the Pandora box, because you know what happened in the plane kind of like made Angelina Jolie file for divorce. And she alleged that actually Brad Pitt was abusing their children, and Angelina Jolie had had enough of his behavior, and only to find out actually after some time that actually this was quite a bit of an exaggeration. Because to be honest, apparently Angelina Jolie was kind of like making up the stories, because they did investigation and they didn't find any abuse on the kids. So this actress Angelina Jolie is a liar, and I'm kind of like really disappointed, to be honest. When I kind of like talk about Angelina Jolie and Jennifer Aniston, I kind of like really like both women. I like Angelina Jolie, that she's kind of like sexy goddess. You know, every man always wanted to be with this woman. You know, you remember in her heydays, she's one of those hot, sexy women with big lips, and you know, men were just going gaga every time they kind of like were filming with her. And she had a reputation of kind of like dating her, you know, her co-stars. That's why it wasn't, you know, shocking that when she was acting with Brad Pitt on the set of Mr. and Mrs. Smith, she kind of like did her charms on him and, you know, managed to steal him from Jennifer Aniston. But now the beef is like, you know, this Brad Pitt allegedly was looking for Jennifer Aniston's number, and he finally got it. And he kind of like, first of all, he wished her a happy birthday. Mm-hmm. You just called me to wish me my happy birthday, excuse me. Allegedly, that's what the papers are reporting, that you know, Brad Pitt reached out to Jennifer Aniston by wishing her a happy birthday. And of course, he's been confiding in her, and I'm kind of like thinking, if you're married to Angelina Jolie, there's gonna be a lot of things you want to get out of the chest. And apparently Brad Pitt has been contacting Jennifer Aniston and really confiding in her. And the good thing is, like, apparently Jennifer Aniston's husband doesn't mind them to, you know, talking to each other or texting each other. But I'll kind of like warn Jennifer Aniston's husband not to really tolerate this kind of behavior. You know, there's an expression that an old garden is not really that difficult to dig back. You know, you can easily fall back in love with your ex if you're not careful. So you shouldn't really take for granted that, you know, Brad Pitt can just be coming in their house and be friendly with his wife. And I think it's to stop this because, you know, we don't want to have another scandal whereby, you know, Jennifer Aniston is getting back with Brad Pitt because, you know, Brad Pitt is quite kind of like one of those white boys who's really hot. You know what I mean? And I'm not being racist. It's kind of like, you hear there's something about eye candy about him. And, you know, sometimes women like Jennifer Aniston can just fall for his charms again. And anyway, this one has been going on. And it's really good that the two kind of like maybe put their differences aside. And, you know, the question now everyone is wondering, are they gonna get back together? And would you love to see them together, or should, you know, Jennifer really not go back to, you know, you don't go back to your vomits once someone does you such dirt. The last thing you need is to be with them again. And I kind of like agree with that. But you guys are welcome to let me know in the comment section, would you kind of like go back to your ex after he cheats on you with somebody else? Or would you kind of like just want to let him speak to you so that you kind of like remind him of what he's missing? Like, yeah, you dumped me, but you're back, baby. And yeah, so we'll keep this story on our list, and we'll be watching how this friendship develops. And I don't know if you watched last time when Angelina Jolie was talking, she was being interviewed by some news network, and she's kind of like talking that actually the two of them are also fine. And she just recently did also a perfume ad. I kind of like think she's an old woman, but she's trying to go back to her old self of being the sexy actress that she has been all along. But well, we'll wait and see, and we hope that, you know, Jennifer Aniston is happy now, because karma is a bitch apparently. Angelina Jolie couldn't keep Brad Pitt, so there's no such thing as a sexy woman, I guess, because you wonder that, you know, who would want to dump, you know, Angelina Jolie, because she's one of those hot women that, you know, men go gaga for her, but apparently she cannot keep a man. There's always a saying that if you are so hot, how come you can't keep a man? That's the question I always ask myself. Anyway, guys, this is what I wanted to share with you today. You're welcome to let me know in the comment section about the whole story. Tell me in the comment, because I don't want to be talking to myself. You tell me in the comment section what you think of this Brad Pitt texting his, you know, married ex-wife Jennifer Aniston. And yeah, I'd like to hear from you. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, bye bye.